Hey everybody, Josh here with another video response to your amazing questions. And this one actually is going to cover how and where to put the drip lube onto the chain. There's a ton of mixed messages out there. Some of that's even ours because we've learned over the years how to do it the right way. And so what we're going to cover today is the perfect way to apply a drip chain lube according to science. If you go all the way back to the beginning of the super secret launch, remember COVID?
Hey everybody, Josh from SILCA here with an exciting announcement from our quarantine driveway, and that is Josh's super secret chain lube. Now, this is a product we've been working on for a little
while. That whole thing, the masks, all that, that was launched in my driveway because... Well, we were shut down here downtown, and I took all that stuff to my house, and we were bottling in the garage and just hoping that somebody would buy something and keep the business alive during COVID, and you did. So thank you. Huge thanks for that. But here is the launch video in my driveway, and here is me.
So let's take a look at how to apply it to the chain. So you want to apply it to a clean, dry chain like we have here, and the key is you want to apply it at the bottom of the chain, on top of the links here at the bottom. On top of the links here at the bottom. So we're gonna open the bottle like this.
Yeah, showing you to put it at the bottom of the, on the top of the bottom span of the chain right before it goes onto the chain ring. Now, why was I doing that? The honest answer there is because that's how everyone else showed how to do it. So I think me growing up in the sport, all the pro mechanics I've worked with over the years, pretty much everybody applies chain lube right at this same spot in this same way. And when we really started to push on the why of it, we found that the why was like talking to any good, you know, three-year-old, because no one could tell me why this was the place to put it on. And so you guys know me, you know how my brain works. That was not a good enough answer. But particularly with the emulsified wax lubricants like Super Secret. So you guys remember Super Secret, according to Zero Friction Cycling, the first wax lubricant ever to fully penetrate the chain on initial application. Now, how did that happen? Well, we developed some really kind of cool, a little bit magical emulsification technology that this is sort of an emulsion slash suspension, ultra, ultra tiny, like, micron scale, particles suspended in water with a tiny bit of alcohol to speed evaporation. And one of the problems with a lubricant that's essentially in a water-based carrier like this is that when you apply it to the bottom span of the chain, as we showed you to do, if you're using a higher-end chain that has a special coating on it, it's typically going to want to run right through. And, you know, I see this in the comments a lot on our products. We get a lot of these questions through our inbox. I've seen other, you know, people on YouTube trying to apply it, and they say, oh, it just wants to run right through the chain onto the ground. And of course, the reason for that is high-end chains have a hydrophobic coating on them. In most cases, it's a hydrophobic coating that is oleophilic, right? So hates water, loves oil. So if you think about it, of course, a water-based lubricant carrier is going to want to just run right through and off of that chain if it has one of these hydrophobic coatings. Really got to thinking about, well, should we apply it, you know, up here on the chain ring or back on the cassette? And so we ran a bunch of experiments here. And initially we were trying to use weight as a proxy for, you know, how much lubricant would be held inside the chain. And we found that a couple of the techniques could get you pretty close to there. So we go into the test lab and we realize that we really can see some subtle but present variation in the quality of a wax drip lubricant like this, depending on where you apply it. Much more so here than with an oil. With an oil-based lube like a synergetic, because it's typically an oleophilic coating and the oil has a high viscosity, it wants to stay put. If it's in the chain somewhere, eventually through the running of the drivetrain, the articulations of the chain links are going to get that spread, you know, through 100% of the inside of the chain. With a chain coating product like this, you know, and I would put it up there, you know, ceramic speed, UFO is in a similar boat, the true tension tungsten, you know, all really high quality wax emulsion products. They all need to dry. And so if they aren't fully distributed and dispersed throughout all of the inner surfaces of the chain before they dry, you can have some dry spots. And so you really want to ensure that you are getting maximum penetration and maximum surface coating. And the place that we found in our testing that was by far the best was right here before the chain hits the top cog or the top of the cassette. So what's the thought process here? And I've got my little dynoscope, dyno light microscope set up so I can show you exactly what's happening. But if you look at the chain from the back when you're cross-chaining it, as I am here, I'm not fully cross-chained, I'm a cog down. But let's look at this, you know, just as a photo, right? You see the chain takes this sort of, you know, chicane, this sort of S shape. And if you think about what's happening in the chain on the cog is straight to itself. And the chain in the top span here is straight to itself. But to make that bend, the chain has to articulate laterally through this bend. And it's the sharpest it's going to be here because you have flex in the derailleur cage at this end. And then the flex here is actually helping align it with the bottom of the ring in front. And so you're having the least lateral articulation up here, a small amount at the here, and then a slightly bigger amount as it hits the rear cog. Why that's important is that that shift, lateral articulation in the chain, acts like a little pump. And it also does one other thing that if you, so it's kind of almost a pump between the side plates. You're opening and then closing and then opening and then closing the wedge between the side plates. But more importantly, the inner plates, which are the actual journal surfaces that the pin of the chain ride on, they articulate laterally and they open up their own wedges between their inner surfaces and the pin itself. And so that's really hard to show. You know, we've got, here's a good CAD image of what's happening inside the chain, and here's what it theoretically looks like articulated. I have to admit, I actually took a couple of chains and I tried to grind them so I could show this, and I just couldn't get a good grind on it to make it work. I probably need a wire EDM or something, which I don't have. So we're not going to do that for this video. But you get the idea from this CAD model that when it articulates, those surfaces, which theoretically are line contact, those open up and become point contact, and then they close, and then they actually articulate in the other direction, opening up that line contact to be a point on the other side. And so you do get this little sort of wedge pumping action. And I brought the dynoscope out here because I really wanted to show you all kind of what that looks like in real time. And so I'm going to take my super secret, which we've pre-shaken. Remember, all these emulsification or emulsified suspended wax-based lubricants, they need to be shaken really well. So, okay. And what I'm going to do here, so I'm going to go ahead and start recording my screen. And so I've got my dynoscope on. This is a little section of Shimano 12-speed Durace XTR chain. And it has been completely stripped and is clean and dry. And so you'll see what it looks like here. You can see here's me kind of touching it. And you can see the wedges that I'm talking about. See, as I articulate it, this wedge opens. And then if you articulate it the other way, the wedge opens. What you can't see here are those inner journals opening like this. But you can imagine that the exact same effect is happening inside the chain under that roller. But to show you how powerful this is, what I'm going to do, I'm going to scoot this chain kind of out of the way, open my lubricant here. And I'm going to put a drop of the lube onto the paper. And so you see my little drop of lube here. Is sitting, you can see it's got, you know, good surface tension against this post-it note that I'm using, and it's stood up nice and tall. I'm going to put the chain right on top of it and then show you how the pump works. It will actually pull the lubricant up into the chain. This is pretty cool. So let's check this out. So there's my lube. I'm going to set it right on top. And you can see it starting to capillary into the bottom of the chain. And look at it capillarying around. And now watch what happens as I pump. Oops. Look at that. It's actually pumping from the bottom up into the top of the chain. And so what we're doing here, when we're placing it on right before it articulates laterally. And what you'll see is if the chain is completely clean and dry, and it's got one of these hydrophobic coatings, it's going to run straight through. And the pumping action is going to open these wedges for it to get in. And then the cog is actually going to help hold it on the bottom side for a second or two so that it doesn't drip through. And that actually is going to really work in our favor, that once you've gone through a time or two, there's actually a thin coating on the cog of the cassette here, and it's going to actually help distribute it through the rest of the chain. But it's really, in the moment, it's just keeping it from dripping through onto the garage floor. That pumping action is going to pump it up in, and then look, we're articulating rotationally around the pin here. We're articulating again here rotationally, here, here, and here before coming off. So you're using the pump to wick the lubricant into the chain, and then you're articulating it around the pin to help distribute that more evenly through the chain. And that is why when we use this method of applying here right before it goes on, we see that we can typically get 1 to 2 tenths of a gram more lubricant into the chain. And that doesn't sound like a whole lot when you think there's, you know, somewhere on the order of typically 5 grams of lubricant is all that's necessary for the entire chain if it's lubricated purely on the inside. So, you know, 5 grams, we're improving that by, call it 1 to 2 tenths. That's not bad. But we are really improving that distribution within the chain, and we're improving that distribution of the higher volume of liquid. You know, you think if you're applying it here, some is running through, you're getting minor articulations up there, and then by the time you're really getting the maximum pumping action back here, anything that could have been lost or come off, it's probably come off. And so chances are you might be getting that little bit of pumping articulating action, but now you're doing it on a lesser volume of lubricant that's inside the chain. And so that is why we say right here is the place, proven by science, to be the best to lubricate your chain. Now, I'm sure you're at home wondering, well, what if I use Synergetic or another oil-based chain lube? Is it the same? And the answer is 100% yes. You know, these all have viscosities higher than water. Some, like our, you know, Synergy, a good bit higher than water. And they eventually will work themselves around, but this really is just the most efficient, fastest way to do it. And I think you'll find in your own, you know, applying of lubricants on your personal drivetrain, you actually use less doing it this way, you know, because none of it is dripping through and off onto the ground. So anything that would have dripped through gets held onto that cassette cog and then redistributed to other links or other parts of the chain. And it really will give you a good indication of, you know, you basically do one drop per link all the way around. And when you're done, you're done. I'll give you my last secret here for using this or any technique with the SILCA Super Secret or any emulsion type chain coating that dries is, if you want the absolute quietest possible ride, what you do is do all of your lubricating up here in this spot, and then quickly run it through the entire cassette, all the way bottom to top. And that will give you just a very thin, you almost can't even see it, coating of the wax lubricant on the cogs. And man, does that make the whole system super, super quiet. But it does it without adding any additional lubricant to the system. You're really just distributing what was on the one cog across the others. And so it'll keep you from having any, you know, excess buildup or any excess lube like you might get if you were to, say, just put a ton of this stuff on to try to, you know, make it even quieter than it normally would be. But it just, that'll give you, I would say in my experience, really 100 kilometers of absolutely just pristine silence as you're riding. So there you go. Apply it here, run it through, let it dry. 8 to 24 hours is ideal for ours, ceramics, but really almost any of them. Yeah, and enjoy. If what questions you have, let me know. Drop them in below. Please like, subscribe, share us with your friends. That really helps. It really helps. Thanks for watching.